TikTok. I don't stop. This is your boy Prime bringing you another little insight about 2K11. This is from your boy Prime. So I'm going to talk about the aspects of the control aspect that goes down in NBA 2K11. So I don't want a lot of players to get this misconstrued. So I want to basically tell you that how basically the controls is. So this is mainly for all you NBA Live players out there that's basically going to make that transition. And so I'm going to give y'all the heads up. So if you know, you know. But if you don't know, your boy Prime is bringing it to you first and on hand right here at the Matrix. So I'm going to break it down to all y'all players out here. Now, as y'all see right here, I got this on the control format right now. And so I brought it up for you so you can actually, so y'all can actually see this. So I'm going to break it down to y'all very, very simple and easy. And then after I get done with this, after I talk about this, and then it can actually get y'all can be a little bit more informative. Y'all can be a little bit more informant and understand more about these controls in NBA 2K11. So we're going to break it down. So they got in like five different formats. They got default control. They got alternate A. They got alternate B and C. I mean, that's only four. I'm sorry. They have four. So out of these four control sets, all these control sets has something good to offer, but they all take something away from the control aspect on where it forces you basically to play on the default control level. So right now I'm going to go to this is the main one that a lot of NBA Live players are going to go first, and I'm gonna tell you why. As you see right there on the bottom of your left of your screen, it's going to say dribble moves. This is where a lot of NBA Live players is basically going to go first for their control aspect because of the way the controls is. Now, I'm going to tell all y'all characters out there the catch to this. Okay, so I'm going to break it down. Now, if you're going to do the dribble moves, you still can do the dribble moves on this alternate B setting, okay? But, okay, when it comes down to the post play, when you're going to do your post play moves, you can't do them. Because the stuff that the shot stick gives you, okay, you're not going to be able to do those moves. I could say the only one that you could basically do is the up and under. That's it. When you do that fake and you do that up and under, when you tap the X, you can do that. But you can't do shimmy moves. You can't do like certain other moves that the shot stick is going to give you. So it's a lot of moves in the post that's going to be taken away from you if you switch to this format. Okay. Next, you can't. What's another thing that they took out? They took out, well, they give you hot step and they take out the fake pass. I mean, they give you that. Everything else is going to be there, okay? But the only thing that they take out is that, you know, you can't do certain moves. Now, certain, like, other stuff, you can't do the particular dunks that you want to do. You can't do the particular layups that you want to do. You can't do drifters. So, you can't do a lot of shots that you can do to oppose to having the shot stick when you put it on this setting. So when you put it on alternate B, you can't do those particular moves, which kind of sucks because, you know, now it basically forces you to play on the default control. So, and that's basically what I want to bring to people. And I have test all these controls. So that's why I say I have a hard time with the control because I'm still trying to find something that's making me feel comfortable with the control. Because that's the only thing with 2K is that it's the control aspect of the game, you know, and, you know, that's the thing that bothers me about the game. So that's why I'm trying to make it a good, you know, say an experience for you, not just for myself, but for other players out there that has trouble with the controls, because the controls are not that good in 2K. You know, a lot of you will agree with me and a lot of you won't, will disagree with me. And that's fine. That's cool. But everybody is entitled to their opinion. So we're going to go to the next one. It's the alternate C. Now, it's the same thing as the, yes, and also with the alternative B, the total control passing is negated. You cannot use it at all. You cannot use total control passing, so that means you cannot use the off-ball aspect with that total control passing. You can't do it. If you want to do quick control passing with your right stick, you cannot use it on alternate B. So that's another insight that you need to understand. So it takes a lot of the control out of the game when you switch your control formats. When you go to alternate C, now you can use the total control passing on that, but you can't use the stuff in the dribble move. You can't use the dribbling. You can't use the shot stick. at all, because it's all for passing. So the shot stick is basically gone, but it does put back up the fake and the hot step. Now you'll be forced only to use the shot button. Same thing with the dribbling, you forced to use your shot button. Same alternate B and alternate she, alternate C, you are forced to use the shot button, but they're totally different stuff. Now with the alternate C, you can use the total control passing on this aspect, you can. But when it comes down to the shot stick and all that stuff, you can't use it. So you can't use it at all. So basically the way 2K has their control aspect, and like I always said before, their controls has always been bad. Regardless of what setting that you put it on, has always been bad. And last but not least, there's two more that I have to do. I'm just skipping around. So I should just went in order, but I didn't. I wanted to get to the main one first. Now, alternate A, okay, now what it does is that it takes the fake pass away and it takes the hot step out. Okay, what it does is, now this is basically a good one if you really don't care about the hot step and stuff like that. What it does is that it gives you a spin button and it gives you a crossover button where it makes it a little bit more easier for players to do the dribble moves. So if you want to do a crossover, you just press the B button. If you want to do a spin move, you do the Y button. So that'll make it a little bit easier for certain players to do certain moves. Now, like I said, it takes out the fake pass. It takes out the hot step. Okay, but you can use total control passing with it. Okay, but it does take out two things that you can use. That fake button is a real good thing too. It also takes out the It also takes something else out. I haven't really tweaked with the alternate A R like that. All I know is that from basically what I've seen is that you can't do what I've did. I tried on the main stuff that the alternate B and the alternate C didn't allow you to have, opposed to the default. And the alternate A. So, and like I said, the alternate A, it takes out the fake pass, it takes out the hot step, when you want to do a spin move, when you want to do a particular spin move, you can't do it because it's only going to give you one spin. So, you know, I mean, it's all messed up. So you have to adjust to certain things. And last but not least, the default control, which is basically the primary setting for everything. So this is basically what they want you to play on. And it's very, very frustrating. It's not frustrating because I'm starting to get down with the control aspect. It's just the response and the control of your players. And that's the thing about 2K that I don't like, because you don't have control of your players. You know, I get sick of certain players and stuff like that talking about, well, this is more realistic and stuff like that. Trust me, it's not realistic with the dribbling. Maybe the dribbling speed of certain players, but the way the game controls and stuff like that, where the computer negates you of doing certain moves, or the slowness of the controls, that's not real life basketball. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not gonna break it down and get into all that. I just wanted to bring this segment to a lot of players out there that are NBA Live players that's making that transition to 2K, so y'all can actually find out a little bit more about the controls. And trust me, you're going to need the fake pass. You're going to need the hot step. You're going to need every single aspect when you get into the post and using every move, because every move that's in the post is with the right stick. Okay? And that's the reason why a lot of players don't go into the post, because they don't want to get into the habit. I'm trying to learn every aspect of the control in the game. So I'm trying to get myself out of it. So it's really, really a difficult transition. But it's time consuming, but you have to be patient and learn how to do it. So I'm just bringing this for all my NBA Live fans out there, because we're not going to have a game for a very, very long time. And, you know, so you have to really, really, you know, see if you can get used to these controls. And it's very, very a hard transition and stuff like that. Just to me, honestly, Live always didn't have better controls. I mean, I don't care what nobody say. So, I mean, I can care less what people say or whatever like that, you know. To get to the point at hand is that control needs to be implemented in 2K. Some players really, you know, they really strive on it because, you know, they like to find the flaws and the faults into the game and take it to their advantage, because a lot of people can't take the controls of the game. So that's all I really want to get to you. You know, a lot of people are going to take advantage of you because you don't know the controls. And that's fine and dandy. You got to take your lumps. But, you know, but back to what I want to say is that the default control is basically the main one that you have to do if you want to get all the moves down pat. Alternate A, what it does is that it takes a fake pass, it takes a hot step, and it takes a certain amount of other moves away from you that you can't do. Alternate B, you can't do total control passing, you can't do post moves with it, you can't do certain moves in the paint when you want to do particular layups, certain dunks. You can't do it because the shot stick implements everything that you need to do on that. Also, it takes away the that this setting does. It takes away the like I said, the post moves as well. Alternate C, like I say, it gives you total control passing, but it takes away the post moves. It takes away a lot of aspects. It takes away a lot from the shot. You can't get in the paint and all that stuff like that. So if you're not using the shot stick for your shooting, it's a lot of stuff that you can't do. The shot stick is a main feature in the game. So thanks for dropping in for the segment of the Matrix people. And you know, I hope y'all enjoyed this little statement that I had brought to you, whatever, like the boy Prime. Leave your comments down and stuff like that, and let me, you know, tell me what y'all think, whatever like that. But other than that, you know, to me, honestly, when it comes down to a good game, you need to have control, and you should be able to control your players when need be on that. So anyway, I'm about to close this segment out. So get ready for all my games I'm about to put up and everything, people. And I'm about to get some more NBA Live 10 games going. And at the same time, I'm about to go ahead and, you know, get some 2K games going too, so y'all can see how I do it and stuff like that. And look out for something special for you on the 2K thing that I got coming up too. So I hope everybody enjoyed this and got a little bit of insight, a little bit of understanding about it if y'all didn't know. So back to what I was saying, if you know, you know. If you don't know, your boy Prime is first letting you know up here on the Matrix. All right, y'all. God bless to you. One.